Hey, good evening, and welcome to the Workers in Berks Show, sponsored by the United Labor Council of Reading in Berks County. My name is Richie McDonough. I'm a proud member of NALC Branch 258 here in Reading, Pennsylvania. And we have a great show in store for you tonight. The Workers in Berks Show talks about issues that affect workers and their families. If you would like to call us tonight, we're live. Today's the 20th of April. And our number at the TV station is 610-378-0426. If you have any questions or concerns about what we talk about tonight, or just want to drop a suggestion, what have you, you can call the Labor Council at 610-374-2725, or visit us on the web at www.sepaalf.org. Okay, we're located at 1251 North Front Street. And before we begin tonight's show, I do have a couple announcements. And by the way, that was the Dropkick Murphys, who are a champion for unions, workers, and their families, at the theme song, Shipping Up to Boston. That always gets me pumped up. So, and I actually do have permission to use that. So our announcements, the 27th annual golf tournament, which is at Willow Hollow, is Sunday, June 5th. So you can contact the Labor Council for more information on that. We need golfers. I know I even sponsored a hole. That's great. The AFL CIO night at the ballpark is Friday, June 3rd. A lot going on that weekend, huh? That's a fun-filled, fulfilling weekend right there. A night at the ballpark and a golf tournament. Doesn't get any better than that. So, in real soon, April 28th at Heritage Park at 6th and Canal Street. And this is, like, really important. No, April 28th is the actual work. It was Memorial Day, but we're celebrating on April 30th. And we're going to have a thing from 12 to 1 at 6th and Canal Street at Heritage Park, where there's a workers' memorial, and that's sponsored by the United Community Services and the steel workers, and that's from 12 to 1 on April 30th. So please join us, and what we do is, you know, stuff we take for granted, like a 40-hour work week or weekends off and some benefits that, you know, are really our natural rights. People fought and died for that. So we go there to mourn those who did and to support those who are still fighting for us. So that's a real important thing. So that's April 30th. And I'm going to ask everybody else, too, out there as a labor person, to please support the striking Verizon workers who've been without a contract for the year, and they're just, you know, they're trying to outsource jobs and make the workers work wherever, like you can, they have it in their contract, you can have to work so many miles within your home. Now they can just go tell you can work here 800 miles away, or, you know, it's nuts, you know, and they want to freeze their pensions, and you know, it's just goes on and on. People, wake up, support them, okay? And those are all my announcements, I think. So tonight's one of my favorite shows, being a letter carrier. We're going to talk about the National Association of Letter Carriers Stamp Out Hunger. I believe it's what, Paul, the 24th?
24.
The 24th, and that's going to, 24th annual, and that's going to be on May 14th, Saturday, May 14th. So we're going to talk about that and who and exactly what it supports, which is our Greater Berks Food Bank. So my guest to my immediate left is Doug Long, who's the Director of Marketing and Development at the Food Bank. Paul Purcell, who's a letter carrier, union brother like myself, and he's our Food Drive Coordinator.
Hi, Rich.
Hey, guys, welcome.
Good evening.
Thanks for being here. So why don't we start with Paul, and Paul, you tell us a little bit about Food Drive, when it is, what we should do, what we need to know.
Okay, well, we're going to start out, as Richie said, it will be Saturday, May 14th, the 24th annual. We usually have it the Saturday before Mother's Day. This one will be the Saturday after Mother's Day. So a little change. It's still the second Saturday in the month, and the week of leading up to the food drive. Richie, if you could hand me that card there.
They can put it up on the screen, okay, too.
You're going to get this little card here that's on the screen in your mail Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, leading up to that Saturday. So what we're going to ask you is when you get that card, go to your pantry, give as much as non-perishable items you can, and Doug will go over what their things they're looking for. And as put it out by your mailbox and whatever time of day, put it out early because we're going to have some people out helping the carriers pick up because we'll be doing double duty that day. It's a big day for the carriers, but as they get your mail, we'll pick up that food and we'll get it out to the food bank. So it's a big day. It's a fun day. You know, one of my, like you said, it's one of our favorite days of the year.
I know it is a great day, and the whole thing about this, I'm sure everybody knows. People always think, well, food is just for you know, you think the hungry or the homeless and stuff. But you know, these days where we have people making decisions whether they can eat or pay an electric bill and things like that, I don't have to tell anybody who lives in this county what's been going on here. And times are really really tough. And as letter carriers, we're out there 6 days a week, and we spend a lot of time, and we're in every single neighborhood. So we see what goes on.
And you were right in the county. People think, you know, the hunger, it's in the city. It's not. It's now throughout the county. It's young, it's old, it's wherever. It's Redding, it's Leesport, it's Boyertown, it's Schuylkill County. It's all over, and, you know, it's becoming more widespread, you know.
Absolutely. In the Greater Berks Food Bank, we have pantries that serve every single community throughout Berks and Schuylkill counties. And so if you're listening and you live in, let's say, you know, Shoemakersville or Kutztown or wherever, and you're giving this donation of food and you're wondering, oh, is this, you know, going to help my own neighbors? Absolutely it is. So wherever you live, you are supporting feeding people right in your own community who need that help.
And that's right. And I was always taught that what we need to do is give where we live. You know, and that's where it goes right back into your neighborhood. And believe it or not, like I said before, it's not the disenfranchised. These are, I'm sure you could tell us too, there's a lot of just working families. And over the years, I've noticed that the givers, you know, the donators of food now, because times are so tough, have become the recipients.
Absolutely. You know, we've heard a lot of those stories through the years, and you know, really over the 10 years or last 10 years, the greatest rise that we've seen in those who are seeking food help really is the working poor. You know, the people who are trying to do the right thing, who do have a job, but they're just not making maybe the salaries that they used to, or they just can't make the ends meet, and they need that little extra help. And also, you know, once again, not just, hunger's not a stereotypical problem. It doesn't just affect you know, those living in the city or those living in the far outreaching areas. It's in our suburban communities and our rural communities, and that's where we've seen a lot of the rise in demand, once again, over the past 10 years.
I know, and it's crazy because now we talk about, like, I remember everybody would give it. It would be like, oh, well, the homeless and all that. But now, like, the big term is working poor because we're out there, the working poor is almost, you know, in the same type of category, people who need assistance and need a hand up, not a hand out. And that's what we're trying to accomplish on the 14th.
Yeah, and this is perfectly timed for, you know, the food bank, because everybody associates food drives during holiday seasons, Christmas, Thanksgiving, but this is actually going to benefit the food bank at the perfect time when school's getting ready to let out. The kids aren't getting those 3 square meals a day, you know, because most schools now, they get breakfast programs, they got the lunch, they got after school programs. So this is going to be really beneficial. So just think about helping the kids. But you know, as you said earlier, Richie, you know, there's people that worked, you know, 40, 50 years in their lives, and now they can't decide, man, I got to pay my bills, I got medicine I got to buy, I got food. You know, you work 40, 50 years, that's something you shouldn't even be thinking about. You should be in, you know, your golden years, enjoying your retirement.
Right.
And just to reiterate your point there, Paul, it's just the importance of this food drive. You're absolutely right. I would guess probably about 85-90% of our food drives happen between October and November, or October and December, because it's the holidays and people naturally think about those who are less fortunate. But hunger is a year-round problem, and a lot of that food drive food that we got back in the fall, and we had, of course, the Boy Scouts help us out in November, a lot of that food is drying up, so to speak, for us right now, and we don't have as much of those food drive, highly sought-after items. So this food drive is great timing for us. And like you said, the kids are out of school in the summer, so we see our needs rise, and this just couldn't be timed any better. Your food drive is for many, many years been our largest food drive of the year, and it really does help us at a time when we need it.
Right. It is the single biggest food drive in the country, and I don't know, like, just nationwide, we've surpassed, like, I know over billions
yeah,
of pounds.
Yeah,
and so again, it's really important. May 14th, which is Saturday, look for the cards in the mail that week. You'll see some other advertisements and stuff. And please remember, if you go to the grocery store, buy a few extra things, because in economically, like, if you break it down, even if you want to donate money, we can donate it to the food bank, like a dollar donation feeds.
We used to brings in $20 worth of food for a dollar
donation brings in 20. Where can you get those odds? Not in the Powerball. You know what I mean? Those are the. I'll take those odds every single time. Imagine that $1 can turn into 20 to help people in your community. You know, and so our drive in this county supports the food bank, which has some wonderful, wonderful programs. So why don't you tell us about
sure. Greater Berks Food Bank, we actually supply 300 programs throughout Berks and Schuylkill County that help our neighbors in need. You know, first and foremost are the food pantries
right.
that we're all familiar with. And like we mentioned a little bit earlier, we have throughout every community throughout our service area, soup kitchens and shelters. We have a variety of programs that deal specifically with children. We have our Produce for Kids program in the city, which delivers fresh produce items, more than 100,000 pounds a school year to kids in the city. We have our backpack program. In our suburban and rural communities, in Berks and Schuylkill counties, we have 18 sites of the backpack program now. It's over 1,500 kids, elementary school kids, the little guys, that are bringing these backpacks home on the weekend now. And last week, we were really excited. We started a brand new program. It's called a mobile food pantry. The idea of that is you take a truck, a food bank truck, and you load it with fresh items, perishable items. The most sought after items, not only because they're the most nutritious, but they're also the items that families that are struggling with their food budgets typically skip because they're the most expensive items.
Isn't that crazy though?
It is.
Right? You know, I go to the store and try to buy healthy stuff and...
You know, it's easy to go to the store and buy the 59-cent off-brand mac and cheese and, you know, you fill your stomach, whatnot, but it does nothing for you. But, you know, the 6-pound, you know, meat or whatever it is, or the $5 a pound produce, obviously they skip that. So we're taking these items directly out to either high-need communities or underserved communities. Last week we piloted the program. We partnered with the Berks Community Health Center right in the 800 block of Penn Street, as well as Redesign Reading. And we had our truck down there, and we had about 8,000 pounds of it was frozen meats, it was sweet potatoes, apples, yogurt, milk, juices, salad, and bread. I think I got everything. But we had more than 225 households that turned out for the first time. And that area there is surrounded by a lot of the senior high rises. So we really only advertised it just in that block. Yeah. You know, we didn't really put the word out because we were afraid we'd get overwhelmed, but just minimally putting the word out, we had about 225 households, which represented, I believe, about 700 people when you count the
right.
kids at home or, you know, grandma living with them at home or whoever it is. And like I said, it was more than 8,000 pounds of these fresh, highly sought-after items. And we just could be more excited about that program. And then going forward with that, we will still serve, with partner such as the health center in the city, but we're really looking at taking that out to some of the further-reaching communities. Maybe some more, you consider more underserved, so whether it's Moton or Wernersville or maybe, up in the Kutztown area, where not, or whatnot. But we're going to start moving that around, and it's just really, really exciting for us.
Wow, it is. I'm excited. Thanks for your service. That's, like, great. I mean, what a dichotomy, though. I'm, like, excited for your program, but I'm, like, ashamed that we have to keep doing this and expanding programs.
Right, right. You know? The need is there. You know, unfortunately, a few years back, when the heat of the recession, you really heard about the economy a lot more. We're not hearing about it as much, but the need still is there. You know, it hasn't gone away at all. It's just tremendous. And we're very fortunate that we have, people like you supporting us and local companies supporting us with food donations and whatnot. We've been able to keep up with that demand, but it's out there.
Oh, okay.
And that's, as you were saying, Richie, it's one of our most important days, one of our fun days, exciting days. But, you hear these stories and, you know what the people at the food bank, they're just trying to come up ways to help people. And how can you not get excited that we're doing this? We start planning in January and, it's 3 weeks away, and wow, I'm excited, you know, and we're hoping for a big day just because the work they put into just to help our community. And, you know, that's what we're asking, you know, help your neighbor. You know, who's getting the food? Probably somebody you know. Guaranteed it's somebody you know, a family member, you know, a neighbor, a friend. It's, somebody's getting it, you know, it's getting the services that the food bank's providing.
So real important, I'm going to keep saying this, Saturday, May 14th, please put your non-perishable items. It's a real simple thing. You just put them in a bag. You leave them out by your mailbox. You don't, no strain. And your mailman will pick them up and we'll get it over to the food bank.
And that's what we say about this food drive. It could not be any simpler.
Right. And our old president, Vince Sombrato, what his quote was, which I loved, was the beauty is in its simplicity. It's real simple. We'd be glad to pick it up and help out the food bank. Well, one of my favorite things, and can you like give us some, just to give the people, they hear about it, but what are the actual stats in this county? Like how many, what's the appropriate term? Food insecure now?
It's food insecure.
Food, I still got it. All right, so see, who said I wasn't politically correct, right? You know, the people say I have no filter, but I got it.
Yeah, we never question it.
Yeah, so how many people in this county are?
As food insecure, in the county, it's probably around 100,000 when you consider the guidelines of what food insecure means. You know, as far as what we serve a year, the Greater Berks Food Bank, just in Berks County alone, about 90,000 people access food assistance at some point during the year. You know, that might be the family that 1 month found themselves in a hard time and went to a food pantry, or it might be the person who's visiting a soup kitchen on a weekly basis. But almost 90,000 people in a county of about 450,000 people. So it's a tremendous amount of people that we're helping out there. And as you know, I always say, we couldn't do it without the generosity of the community.
Right. So, come on, there's a quarter of the community just about needs some help as far as food. You know, so we need to get out there, put our bags out on the 14th. Here's the one that always gets me. So out of the food insecure, how many of those are children?
About 40% of those we serve are kids that are under 18 years of age.
40% of those you serve are kids.
And another 10.
Why should any kid go
absolutely
hungry
not.
Or
absolutely
be food not. Insecure? That's ridiculous. And the harm that that does, and I want to talk about Kids Cafe, the harm that that does just for their brains and not being able to learn, it does immeasurable exponential damage to, you know, we hear all the TV, the children are our future and all this stuff, but, you know, we're sitting in a county where 40% of the kids are hungry.
I was going to say, you know, that's why the food bank, you know, obviously our job is to get food out to anybody who is hungry and needs food, regardless of age, but we have a real special emphasis on kids through our Week in Our Backpack program, through Produce for Kids, then also through seniors. You know, I said 40% are kids.
Again,
but also
the other end of the spectrum.
Another 10% are seniors.
These people who work their whole lives, you know what I mean?
Absolutely.
It, blood, sweat, and tears, and now.
And once again, that's a number that we see rising. And
that is rising.
As the baby boomers go through, and people are living longer lives now, which is a wonderful thing. However, on the flip side of that, what you're seeing
what's
is a lot
the
of
quality?
People.
Yeah, yeah.
The quality are a lot of people who are outliving their pensions, outliving their savings, and it's sad. And like I said, it's about 10%. So 50% are your adults that fall in the middle, but 50% total of what we serve are kids and seniors.
Yeah, and we're talking about the kids. They're the innocent people. They don't know understand why. They just know there's no food on the table. You know, they don't know why mommy and daddy can't, you know, bring the food in. They just know there's no food sitting there for them. And, you know, as you said, it's 30% of the, is kids, and another 10% is the senior.
And that was, and that's what the whole, in the, what you found, and I remember this, is the outgrowth of, you know, the kids being in school and having kids' cafes and stuff and getting assistance, but then they would go home on the weekends and have nothing to eat, and hence you came up with the backpack.
The backpack program. And as well as the Produce for Kids program, send them home with healthy foods for the home.
For the home. Right. How great is that? Yeah,
right. Now, I know you're looking for any type of food. Is there something specific, you know, we can put out to people?
You know, really the easiest thing, once again, with food drives like this is just to say any non-perishable foods. You know, so we're talking anything that's canned, anything that's boxed, like popular items are always cereals and pastas are great. Also, even bottled items. Try to steer away from the glass items, but yeah, if you have glass, you know, plastic bottles of peanut butter is always a fantastic item. Tuna, cans of soup, but really any non-perishable food. You know, obviously we want food that's in good quality, so right. if you're clearing out your cabinet and you found that,
now,
that can of soup that yeah. fell back there in the late 70s, and yeah. we don't want that, yeah. you leave that one go, or anything that's, you know,
and the boxes
whatever,
and cans shouldn't be open either.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, so, right. We want food of good, you know, first-rate quality, but really anything that's non-perishable.
Oh, that's great. So again, I hope people pay attention, you know, because we need the help. And on May 14th, which is a Saturday, so Friday night or early Saturday morning, take your non-perishable food items and start thinking about it. So you go to the grocery store, grab a thing of cereal for a couple of bucks or something. You know, and you could also donate money to the food bank. You let it carry, we'll pick it up. Also,
there's a way to do that online.
But there's also a way to do that online.
Sure. Berksfoodbank.org. So if you're maybe going to be out of town on the 14th and you can't leave the food out for your letter carrier, you can certainly visit our website, Berksfoodbank.org, and donate. And as you mentioned earlier, one of the really amazing things we always like to tell our donors is that for every $1 donated to us, we're able to acquire $20 worth of food. The reason for that is every year we distribute more than 7 million pounds of food, and over 80% of that food is donated to us. The food doesn't have a cost to us. However, we need trucks and we need drivers and we need fuel to go to around to all those, you know, wonderful food owners that are giving us the food, or go out to pick up food drive items and bring it in. So the monetary donations simply allow us to have more trucks and get out there more and get more food for those who need it. So it's monetary donations are wonderful as well.
Okay, so we've 7 million pounds of food a year has been distributed in this county.
Yes, we're over, actually last year was over 7.25 million pounds of food that were distributed in Berks and Schuylkill counties.
Berks and Schuylkill counties, so that's like really important. So,
I would just want to touch on one thing, Richie. When we were saying about leaving the food out with the volunteers, you're going to have some volunteers out helping the letter carriers, because it's just such a big task. You know, we're doing delivering the mail, we're also picking up mail, we're picking up food also. So we're going to have volunteers out there, let alone it's the biggest food one-day food drive. It's also the biggest one-day volunteer event in the country. So you're going to see some people out there. Don't get excited. You know, they're going to have could have a postal shirt on, could have the Blue Union shirt on, could have this Gray Union shirt on, or have a food drive t-shirt on. So, you know, if you're somebody pulling up in a truck and has a food drive poster on their truck, they're one of ours helping out. And also, Doug lined up some volunteers. If you're interested in that, you can contact the food bank also, and, you know, we'll put you to work that day if you're looking to help out, you know, in more ways than just putting food out.
Yeah, and I just want to say that it is called the Letter Carriers Food Drive because we're in the neighborhoods 6 days, now 7 days a week, and we know our customers, and we do see the need, and we're really grateful that we have the jobs that we have, and we're not food insecure, you know, so we try to do what we can. And but it's just not the letter carriers, because the Postal Service is behind us and is letting us use the carte blanche, giving us the equipment to use and letting us use the equipment. So they're a big supporter.
United Way, the local Teamsters.
I can't say enough about.
Every year they come through for us.
Is it 429? Thank you in advance and for all your past hard work.
And, you know, it starts all the way from United Way, the rural carriers, APWU. They're just postal unions, but, you know, we have the UFCW. They helped out and sponsored with the cards this year. There's just so many people helping out, and, you know, we're just asking the simplicity. Just, you know, put out what you can, and, you know, let's start turning this thing around.
Right. So I'm expecting a lot of donations again on Saturday, May 14th. Start thinking about it now. Picking up a couple items here or there. Tell your kids, you know what, a blessing it is. My kids, you know, she goes to school and announces it and has her own little food drive, you know. And, you know, we always say we're lucky with gratitude. I was always taught, you know, being lucky and having gratitude isn't a feeling. It's an action. You know, it's an action verb, you know. And there are people, your neighbors, your families in this community 50% of which are either elderly or children who need some help. So we're asking you to please do it, to support the Greater Berks Food Bank. And again, you can also give donations, and a dollar donation will get you $20 worth of food, which means, and I went to high school, so if you give $10, that's
200.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
So it's like the food bank is one of my favorite places of all time.
Yeah, they do good work. You know, they're a hidden gem in this county. You know, for the work they put out.
And we want to say congratulations because you just had your 1 year birthday.
We just celebrated, yes, our 1 year in our new facility, and in Singing Spring, we cannot be more excited at the immediate returns that we had on the new building. Not only did we increase the amount of food we distributed in our first year there, but more importantly, we drastically increased the amount of fresh and perishable items, things like fruits and vegetables and dairy items and meats and, you know, really the healthiest of foods. We actually increased by 25% over the previous year because we have larger freezer space, larger cooler space. And once again, we're just really grateful that the generosity of the community allowed us to make the move into the larger building. And it's paying off, as I said, dividends for neighbors who need it.
Right. And so thanks to the community for giving where you live and helping us. And I remember when you were on Neversink Street, It was actually on my mail route, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So the kind of shame is that you had to get bigger and bigger and bigger, and we address that. So remember, ladies and gentlemen, please, on May 14th, put your non-perishable items outside in bag, box, however much you want to put out in your letter carrier. We'll pick that up, or one of the off-duty letter carriers will pick that up, and all that food will go to the Greater Berks Food Bank. There's no other better place that deserves that. It helps the whole community in Berks and Schuylkill County. So thanks, guys, for being here, Paul and Doug, and we'll see you next month.
Thanks, Rich.
Thanks, guys.